If you've been using an app, Flo, Ovia, Natural Cycles, any of the other hundreds of Get Pregnant Quick apps, there's a chance that the app is the reason why you're not pregnant yet. Now, don't get me wrong, there are 100 factors of what makes us get pregnant in a timely manner, but I want you to be careful because sometimes we use apps thinking they're the end-all be-all answer to everything, and they might actually be the reason why you're not pregnant. I did a research study, nothing formal, but my own research study, and I'm gonna share what I found in this video, which makes me think this app might actually be the reason why you're not pregnant yet. Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. If you happen to be someone new stopping by, welcome. My name is Dr. Nicole. I'm a pelvic floor specialist, and I'm also very, very interested in all things women's health because I happen to be a mom too. I've actually gotten pregnant 3 times now. I have 2 living little boys and I kind of know how this whole getting pregnant thing goes, although there's always unexpected things that happen. But over the last month, I ran a little experiment with some of the, I would say, rather common apps. I actually did a little Google search and looked up like 10 most popular apps being used to get pregnant. And the 3 that I chose were the Natural Cycles app, the Ovia app, and the, which reminds me, I need to cancel, Flo app. The Flo app was the 3rd. So we got Natural Cycles, Ovia, and the Flo app. And I wanted to compare when they said I was ovulating, how they were able to take the information I was inputting into them and predict when the best time to have sex is in order to get pregnant. If you've watched any of my past videos, I may even link one above, ovulation, knowing when you ovulate, is crucial for getting pregnant. There's only a 24-hour window where your egg is present, and sperm can only live in your body for about 5 days. So if that sperm and egg aren't in the same place at the same time, there's no chance you're getting pregnant, like not even a little bit. So it's really important that you time intercourse within that very, very small 6-day-ish window of time. So many of us use apps to say, okay, when is a good time to have sex? When is a good time or non-important time to have sex if we're trying to get pregnant? I took these 3 apps, I put in all of the same information into all 3 apps. The information that I put in was when my period was for the last 3 months. I put in any signs of ovulation that I had tracked, like cervical mucus and so on. And if it allowed me to, I put in my basal body temperature for the last month, which is pretty much the only amount of time that I've actually been taking and tracking my basal body temperature, which is a big fancy word for my body temperature in the morning before I get out of bed. I took an ovulation test, but I didn't put the results into the app. I wanted to see if the app would be able to figure out when I was ovulating without the like gold standard of the ovulation stick, because many of us aren't using ovulation sticks at first. We're just kind of using the app and trying to time sex accordingly. We're a little bit more nonchalant about it, so we haven't gotten to the nitty-gritty of like ovulation sticks. So I wanted to see, could the app pick up on all the other signs of my body to know when I'm ovulating, or was it way off? So I put all the information into the app and I compared what they said my ovulation date was, or my fertile window, before I put the ovulation test in, and then I put the ovulation test in and I will go over how they adjusted accordingly. So with the Natural Cycles, Flo, and Ovia app, I'm gonna talk about the best and worst things about each app, the cost of each app, people that I think each app would be really good for, and then finally, I'm gonna tell you what my choice is or what I'm gonna be using moving forward as I continue to try to get pregnant. Let's start with the Ovia app. So the Ovia app is really cool in the sense of that it is completely free. There is no cost associated with the Ovia app, which is always great when you're thinking about starting a family, and saving your pennies is really, really important. Or you're just a cheapskate like me and you don't like spending money on things. Some of the best things that I really loved about the Ovia app were that all of the information that you were inputting, there were like little symbols and colors and different things to see all the inputs on the main calendar. So I felt like I could just easily open the calendar and get a good idea of things that were going on. Something else really great about it is it allowed you to put in so much detail and so much information. Actually, sometimes it felt like it was a little too much information. You could put in sleep, you could put in fitness, how much water you drank, how much food you ate, what kind of food you ate. Like, there were so many things that you could input into the app. Now, I don't think those are necessarily all related to your fertile window, although they do have lots of other features in the app to help you increase fertility, and for sure the things that we're eating and our body weight and exercise and all these things are factors when it's like time to get pregnant. So I think they use that information to kind of give you other extra additional hints and tips for getting pregnant. The ideal user for the Ovia app is someone that loves to track everything. As I've already mentioned, there was so much detail that you could put into the tracker. And so if you want to keep track of all that stuff anyways, this is a perfect choice for you. Now, of course, you don't have to put all that in every time, but for someone that loves detail, this is a really, really good option. Next, let's talk about the Flo app. The Flo, I feel like, is really popular, and there might actually be different variations that are all using the same word. But here's the Flo app that I use. You can see a little bit what it looks like inside. And as far as the cost, what I figured out with a little bit of trial and error is that the app is actually free. But when you look it up online, like I wanna sign up for the Flo app, it makes it seem like you have to have a premium account to start using it, which actually isn't true. They do give you a free month using the premium app, so that's what I did. I just am trying it for free, and then I have to remember to cancel. And then after that, it's $39.99 per year subscription of the Flo app. But like I said, there is a free option. It just feels like it was a little bit like mischievous or tricky in the way that you signed up. The best things about the Flo app were that the calendar was really, really simple. It wasn't overwhelming. There wasn't a ton of information. It was just really simple to read. You could easily see like fertile window, not fertile window, very simplistic. The things that I didn't really love about the Flo app were that there was no place to input basal body temperature, which I feel like is definitely more one of the more reliable things to tell me when I'm ovulating. And it wasn't like they don't really use it. It was like there wasn't even an option to put it into the app. And then the other thing was signs of ovulation. I felt like there wasn't a whole lot of detail about ovulation pain or cervical mucus or position of cervix and different things like that. It definitely like asked if you were having signs of ovulation, but it didn't like, I don't know, it seemed like a lot of work to really elaborate on that, which makes me think that they're not considering any of those things when they come up with your fertility window and the actual day that you're ovulating. Using the Flo app is absolutely perfect if you are a very simple person that's like, I just want bare minimum, I want the most basic calendar to tell me when I'm ovulating. And also if you're using ovulation sticks along with an app. I'll get to why that's important in just a minute here, but what you need to know for now is if you're not using an ovulation stick and inputting that information into the app, it's going to be not very accurate. The Natural Cycles app was the third app that I looked at, and it's a little different than the others because no matter how you use it, there is no free version. I think you can get like a free first 14 days or a month. I can't remember. I think 14 days, which isn't really enough to even track a whole cycle, but you can do a free version of it. But then after that, you have to pay $79.99 for a full year subscription or $9.99 for a monthly subscription. And there's a few reasons why that is true. But just know that there is no free option at this point. The things that I really loved about the Natural Cycles app were that the calendar where you can kind of get like a month view of what's going on was brightly colored, really easy to read without like reading words, but just like the colors kind of told you what was going on. It was fairly simple and there was enough detail on it to be able to tell me what was going on during my month. The other really nice feature on the Natural Cycles app is it had a beautiful graph of your basal body temperature. So if you are a natural family planning or you like to track basal body temperature because that tells you where you are in your cycle, the graph is right on point for that. The other thing is it gives you lots of opportunity to input information about ovulation and what's going on with your cervix and your cervical mucus and ovulation pain and all that kind of stuff very easily within the app, which made me feel like I could input the information that I knew or true signs of ovulation in my body without just relying on algorithms to tell me when I was ovulating. One of the things I didn't really love about the Natural Cycles app was that you have to put in basal body temperature every morning pretty accurately in order for the app not to rely on an ovulation stick to tell you when you're ovulating. So this is one of those like pros and cons. It's awesome because it's using something that doesn't cost any money, that's very natural, to tell me when I'm ovulating, which is your body temperature. But let me tell you, I guess, a story or an example. When we went on vacation in Mexico, we were staying up later than normal, plus there was an hour time change. We weren't getting up as early as normal. I would often have to pee in the night because we were drinking at night. Also, having drinks at night affects your body temperature. So all those things kind of messed up my body temperature for about a week. Then when I got home, one of the first or second nights home, my little guy woke up around 4 a.m. And so I got up to tell him, like, it is not morning yet. We are not getting up. And then went back to bed. And my normal, like, wake-up time that I've been taking my temperature around is 5:30. So unfortunately, that reading wasn't going to be accurate because you really need to be in bed, like, getting about 3 to 4 hours of sleep in a row, before you want to do the reading. So if I just got up at 4 and then I go to do the reading at 5:30, it might not be accurate. Now, it definitely leaves room for those situations, and you can like tell them, I don't think this was an accurate reading. So it'll kind of like throw it out if it's obscure. And it also, it says basically if you can get five to six readings a week that are accurate, then the app can still like do its job and get a good idea of what's going on in your body. So it does give room for that error. It just makes it a little bit trickier. But the other apps aren't even considering basal body temperature at all in the algorithm. So it probably means this app is more accurate. So I don't know. There's a give and take there. But that was the one thing that I didn't really love about the Natural Cycles app. This app is absolutely perfect for people that are using the app and tracking basal body temperature as a form of birth control. Kind of already has your cycle down pat. So it's a really cool option. I'm really excited because it'll be something I can use for birth control after my period starts again, God willing that we are able to get pregnant, something that I can continue using down the road, and it'll already have lots of information kind of stored and data collected on me, if that makes sense. This is probably the most important part of the video if you are trying to get pregnant, and that is the accuracy of Flo, Ovia, and Natural Cycles when it comes to predicting ovulation, because like I said, you have to have intercourse in that very small window. If you do it too early, if you do it too late, you're definitely not going to get pregnant. So let me tell you exactly what I found when I was inputting information into these apps without the information of the ovulation stick. That's like the gold standard that I measured the accuracy against, because we know that ovulation sticks are like 99% effective in telling you when you're ovulating. And it also matched up with all of the signs that were going on in my body. The sticks match my body. Unfortunately, the stick in my body did not match all of the apps. In fact, two of the apps were like way, way off. So let me just tell you what I found. The day that my body and the ovulation stick said that I was ovulating was October 4th. So that's gonna be the gold standard for this little research project that I did. So knowing that I ovulated on October 4th, let's start with what the Flo app said for my fertile window. And unfortunately, the Flo app was actually the most inaccurate in telling me when my fertile window was. So as you can see here, the app says that my fertile window was between September 25th and September 30th. So if sperm can only live in my body for 5 days, that means that if I had sex on every day of my fertile window, the sperm from September 29th and September 30th might have lived long enough and still been in my body by October 4th, given that 5-day rule. But other than that, all the other sperm would be long gone, not there anymore. And because the app said my fertile window was over, if I was really having a lot of intercourse during that 5-day window, kind of exhausted, tired, and not really interested in sex for a few days, and didn't have it again before October 4th, I would have almost completely missed my window. Definitely missed my prime day, which is having sex like the day before and the day of ovulation. So this app, unfortunately, just was not very accurate. Now, once I put my positive ovulation stick or LH positive result into the app on October 4th, because that was the day that the stick showed positive. It did change my fertile window from September 30th to October 6th. So this was a much, much more accurate picture of when my actual fertile window was. And hopefully for the next month, knowing that I ovulate closer to day 18 in my cycle, the app would be able to adjust. But when you're first getting started with the app, even though I was putting in all the signs of ovulation, it was still predicting that ovulation was gonna happen on day 14, which is a very like average day for ovulation. Unfortunately, it is not when all of us ovulate. There is like a window of time in there when we might ovulate, and just guessing based on everyone's averages and not really taking into account any of the information that I was putting into the app was a little bit disappointing. So again, just make sure you're using ovulation sticks and putting that information into the app. To make sure that you are not missing your fertile window. That being said, the first month that you use the app, because you can't put ovulation in until basically the last day of ovulation or the last day of your fertile window, that month is pretty much gonna be a wash unless you got lucky and accidentally ovulate exactly on day 14 and happen to have intercourse at just the right time. The next app we'll look at is the Ovia app. This came in second place out of these three apps. The Ovia app actually predicted my ovulation to be somewhere between September 27th and October 2nd. And as I said, ovulation actually happened on October 4th. So at least we would have 3 days where sperm could maybe still be there, which would be, you know, the 2nd, the 1st, and September 30th. So there was one more possible day that sperm could have been in the right place at the right time. They actually predicted ovulation was around day 16, which made me feel like they were actually taking into account the information I was inputting rather than just saying everyone ovulates on day 14. So I really did like that about the Ovia app. But again, unfortunately, it completely missed my most fertile 2 days of the month, which were October 3rd and October 4th. Now, once I put the ovulation test in, it went ahead and adjusted my day of ovulation to September 30th to October 5th, which was, again, a much more accurate window and picture time when I really should have been having intercourse. So it did adjust, and again, it's just one of those apps where you really need to be using ovulation sticks. Otherwise, it's probably not going to be as accurate as you would like it to be. And finally, let's talk about the Natural Cycles app. When it comes to the accuracy of the Natural Cycles app, it's kind of funny because it also originally said my fertile window was going to be starting around September 26th. That is around like day 14. So it was saying like, this is probably when it's gonna start. But because I was inputting basal body temperature, and it was waiting for that spike in my temperature to say, yes, you have for sure ovulated, it kept moving my fertile window. So it started out saying September 26th was gonna be my first day, and it continued to say fertility likely, fertility likely, fertility likely, peak fertility, like it kept moving all the way until October 8th when my temperature finally went up and it could finally say, okay, yes, you have indeed ovulated. So this would have been a little bit frustrating if we were having intercourse every day of our fertile window, because let's see, that is from the 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That would have been 13 days in a row of intercourse, which, I mean, I like intercourse, but like that is a lot of intercourse. But on the flip of that, at least we wouldn't have thought we had intercourse during our fertile window and then later realize we like completely missed the boat. So I guess I would rather have an app say, keep having sex just in case this is the fertile window, rather than telling me, yep, your fertile window has passed. You can go ahead and like relax for a little bit. And again, just like the other two apps, once I put in that positive test for LH positive test or ovulation test, it did adjust and say, okay, your fertile window was actually from 9:29 to 10:05, which was pretty much exactly what the other one said and was very accurate with what my body was telling me. So when it comes to my final conclusions about my research project, the first takeaway is especially that first month, do not rely solely on the app to tell you when you're ovulating, because it is just making a random guess according to how long your period is and the average of when everyone in the world ovulates. So don't take that as gospel. Like, there's a good chance it's wrong, especially the first month. Second takeaway, as far as I'm concerned, if you're using Ovia or Flo, you have to take an ovulation test. You have to see if you have LH hormone in your urine to be able to know when you actually are ovulating. You can keep using it for months and months, and if you never put in an LH positive test, it's probably going to continue to be inaccurate month after month after month. Now, the third takeaway is if you're using an app like Natural Cycles that is tracking your basal body temperature and you are doing it pretty like religiously, you're doing it in the morning before you get out of bed within the same window that it allows each day, then there is a good chance that that is accurate and will become more accurate as it learns you. Now, as I said, I only inputted periods for 3 months and then 1 month of like basal body temperature tracking. So it will take a while for the app to really get to know me, but definitely the most accurate and the one that actually adjusted with things other than the ovulation stick test. So if you wanna know what I'm gonna be using for the remainder of my time trying to get pregnant, it is the Natural Cycles app. I just felt like it was the most reliable. I don't feel like I have to go out and buy ovulation tests each month. That's just an expense I don't wanna have right now. And I also feel like it's something that I can continue to use and it's gonna continue to collect data for me and adjust for me even after a pregnancy, and I can use it as a form of birth control. So I purchased Natural Cycles myself, but after using it and being like, yeah, I really like this app. I like how it works. I like how it predicts ovulation and could help me get pregnant or not get pregnant. I reached out to them and I asked if they ever work with affiliates. They do, and they were actually able to offer me a discount code. You will see that 20% off discount code in the description. So make sure you use that code if you do decide to sign up for a year of Natural Cycles, and you can save a little bit of money and also help me out, which is like double win right there. Bottom line, don't rely solely on an app. Definitely don't ignore the signs of your body and just rely on an app to figure out ovulation. If you're clueless about what the signs of your body ovulating are, this video over here is going to be the very best place for you to head next. Thanks for sticking with me. I know this was kind of a long video, so I'm sorry about that, but there's just so much information I wanted to share. Thanks for watching. I will see you all in the next video.